Friends, we traveled enough in the arena of Dr. Wolf's electroacupuncture with the guidance and margadarshan of Professor Chanchal Agarwal ji. In our journey of understanding Dr. Wolf, Professor Chanchal Agarwal ji made it as simple as possible and given us confidence that we are, you know, able to understand and have our confidence as to second to none. We are second to none compared to allopathic doctor. So much deeply, you know, she has able to convey every minute details about, you know, the physiology and anatomy involved in Dr. Wolf's method. Chanchal Agarwal ji has thoroughly understood the philosophy and motto of Shri Mata Prasad Khemka ji and our samsthan. And we are all blessed and very proud to get guidance from Professor Chanchal ji. I don't want to take much of your time. I'll hand over the session, today's session, to Professor Chanchal ji for yet another journey on understanding Dr. Wolf. So thank you, friends. On behalf of every one of you, I again extend a very hearty welcome to our beloved Professor Chanchal ji and hand over the session to her. Thank you, friends. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ananda sir. Thank you, Ishan. And thank you, every one of you, for joining the session of Dr. Wolf's Meridians. And in continuation of this journey, we'll be learning a new meridian, a very, very beautiful meridian, and that is skin meridian. Okay. So today, we'll be understanding more about skin degeneration vessel, or it is also called SK meridian. We have already covered a few meridians according to EAV, electroacupuncture, according to Dr. Wolf. And we have seen that there are few meridians on the palm. There are four. There were four tissue meridians on the palm, and there are four tissue meridians on the foot. Okay, and one tissue meridian is around the eye. So of the four tissue meridians which are present on the foot, we have already covered two. What are these two tissue meridians which we have already covered? So this is the foot. Yes, one is JD meridian. So this was the location of JD meridian. This is JD meridian. What is the other meridian which we have covered? Yes, fibroid degeneration meridian. So we have seen on the third toe, we have fibroid degeneration meridian. On this third toe only, we have another meridian which we are going to cover today, and it is on the other side, it is SK meridian, skin meridian. Okay, so this side is actually called the tibial side, and this side is called fibular side because of the presence of the bones tibia and fibula in the leg, in the lower leg below the knee. Okay, so since there is a bone here which is called tibia on the upper part, and here is a bone which is fibula. So we will say on the third toe towards the fibular side, we have SK meridian. Fine. This is a very beautiful meridian. After understanding this meridian, you will understand how many problems you can treat through this simple meridian, which consists of only 7 points. So understanding only 7 points, we can treat n number of problems related to skin. So before going into the detail of each point and understanding about this meridian, first let us understand what skin is. What is skin? So skin we have been knowing as a part of sense organs since childhood. How many sense organs are there? 5 sense organs are there. So what are the 5 sense organs? Eyes, nose, ear, tongue, and skin. So skin, we have always been knowing as the largest organ of the body, which covers the whole body, skin. But little detail is missing apart from that, it is the largest organ, one of the sense organ, largest organ, which covers the whole body. So understand the skin. Skin has a total surface area. It covers the whole body. Outside it covers the whole body, and inside also it covers different organs, muscles, nerves, bones, etc. And that type of skin is actually called fascia. F-A-S-C-I-A. Fascia. So fascia is the covering which covers the bones, the organs, nerves, muscles, and covers it and keeps it in place. That is also skin, but that is not called skin. We call it fascia. But we are talking about skin as an organ. So what is this skin? So skin, if we say, has a surface area, and you can calculate your body's surface area. How much skin is there in your body? To calculate, there is a formula. The formula says total surface area of skin, of our skin. If we are calculating our own skin surface area, then the formula is weight in kg into height in meter into 71.84. So 71.84 is a constant which we multiply with weight and height, then we get the total surface area of the body. Okay. Now, if we understand this skin microscopically, so microscopically, if we see this skin, then the thickness of skin is thickness. How thick do you think the skin is? What is the thickness of the skin? Any idea? The skin, how thick it would be? Just an arbitrary guess. No, I'm talking about the thickness, not width. The thickness of skin. If you insert a needle, how thick it would be? 5 mm. Okay. Any other guess? Just give any idea. 0 mm. 4.0 mm. Okay. 0.0 mm, very thin. Very thin is a vague answer. Huh? Give some number. 2 mm. Okay. Many of you are very close to it. It is actually 0.1 mm to 4 mm. What is 0.1 mm? 0.1 mm is, if this distance is 1 mm, this is 1 mm. So you divide it into 10 parts. So that is 0.1. 10 parts of 1 mm. So you can understand how thin it is. And it may be up to 4 mm thickness. So itni fine layer se lekar 4 mm tak ka jo area, that can be that is actually the thickness of skin. At some places it is very thin, at some places it is very thick. Thin areas are, for example, thin areas of body, thin skin on the part of body. Example is lips. Yes, lips, the skin is very fine, very thin. And that is why you don't use what you apply on the body. You have special lip balm, special structure, special things which you apply on the lip, because this lip has so very fine structure of skin that water evaporates very fast. That is why you cover it with thick Vaseline or something which is thicker intensity. Okay. Lips are very thin. Also the skin of anus. Yes, anus skin is also very thin skin. Thick skin is, yes, thick skin is seen on foot and palm. Foot means the sole and palm. So this skin is very thick skin. Okay. Now, if we see a section of skin, how does it look like? And what are the different parts of it? So understand, if we see a section, then it has actually two parts. The upper part is called the epidermis, and the lower part is called dermis. So how many parts do they say? I say skin has two major parts. One is epidermis and second one is dermis. And below dermis also you will see at some locations a labeling is there which is called hypodermis. You will understand what this hypodermis is. Just understand below dermis you have hypodermis. So topmost layer is epidermis. Then you have dermis. Below dermis is hypodermis. I'll show you one picture that will make your imagination. Okay, so what to understand here is only this part. See only this part. The topmost layer is epidermis, then is a layer of dermis, and then is hypodermis. Fine. Now, think only about the topmost layer and it is epidermis. So, epidermis consists of five more layers. First, understand there's epidermis, then hypodermis, then epidermis, then dermis, then hypodermis. This epidermis has five layers into it. So epidermis, vertical section of skin shows, number one, epidermis, and number two, dermis. Now this epidermis, we are talking about epidermis. What is this epidermis? Epidermis is a very thin layer. Very thin. Because it is a topmost layer. Usually the cut which we have with knife or something, if it is not a deep cut, it cuts only the epidermis. Okay, the superficial layer. Thin layer. It is a very thin layer. Non-vasculature. Okay, non-vasculature means the vessels are not there. So you will say, if vessels are not there, then how come the blood comes out? If the blood is coming out, that means it is going deeper into the dermis. If you are scrubbing your foot, the sole, with a scrubber, does blood come out? No, blood doesn't come out. Why? Because you're scrubbing only the epidermal layer, that means the topmost layer. When you go for pedicure, and the topmost layer is removed from the foot, what is that? That is actually the epidermal layer, topmost layer. Okay. It is the outermost part. In contact with atmosphere. So this is a layer which is continuously in contact with atmosphere. And this layer, as I said, consists of five more layers. Okay. So it has five layers in it. What are the five layers? Number one, just write down the names. Stratum, corneum, corneum, stratum, corneum. Second layer is stratum lucidum, lucidum, stratum lucidum. Third layer is stratum granulosum, granu, granulosum, losum, granulosum. Fourth layer is stratum, stratum is strata. Strata means layer. Stratum spinosum, S-P-I-N-O-S-U-M. And fifth layer is stratum basale, B-A-S-A-L-T. Okay, so these are the five layers of epidermis. Out of these five layers, the first three layers are also called horny zone, Z-O-N-A, horny zone. Okay, and the next two layers are considered under germinative zone. Fine. So three layers are called horny zone. Horny because it is actually the dead, at times the outermost stratum corneum is shed off also. Okay. And the lower one is germinative zone because it germinates and it comes out and again the new layer develops. That is why it is called the germinative layer. Fine. Now what about this stratum corneum? What is this layer stratum corneum? Stratum corneum is the outermost layer of skin. It is dead and ready to shed off. It does not have any nucleus, no nucleus. What about stratum lucidum? It is present below stratum corneum, below stratum corneum, C-O-R-N-E-U-M. Some nuclei are present. And cytoplasm is achromatic. What is the meaning of achromatic? That means there's no pigmentation here. Whatever color you are seeing is because of the layer which are present below it. If you see only this layer, it's transparent. There's no color only in this layer. So in the second layer, there's no color, no pigmentation. Okay. Now stratum granulosum, as the name suggests, granulosum means it must be containing some granules. Okay, so it is a layer which is present below stratum lucidum. Stratum lucidum ke niche present hai, stratum granulosum. It consists of 2 to 3 cell strata. That means it is 2 to 3 cell thickness. Cells are diamond shaped. Only understand this part. 2 to 3 cell strata and the cells are diamond shaped. What about spinosum? Spinosum is a layer which is a part of germinative layer. Okay. And it is 4 to 5. It's a thick layer. 4 to 5 cell thickness. Polyhedral cells. Cell shape is polyhedral, okay? And pigments are synthesized here. This is a very important one. Pigments are synthesized here. So if I say that which layer produces pigments, it is actually the stratum spinosum which is producing the pigments. Okay, and because of this layer, we can see the color of the skin. So pigments are actually the melanin pigment, which is giving the color to the skin. Now the last layer, which is stratum basale, it is the innermost layer. Innermost layer. It is single layered. And cells are columnar. Cells are columnar. That is column shape. So total how many layers are there in epithelium? There are 5 layers. Why did I discuss so much about skin? What was the use of understanding these layers? Why are we discussing about this? There was only one and only motive, because in the points you will not get these classifications. There is no use of only when we are studying about Dr. Wolf's points, and nowhere you will get to know about stratum corneum or lucidum or granulosum or spinosum or basale. This is not mentioned anywhere. Why did I mention this? I mentioned it for a reason, and the reason being, this is because of modern medicine. We are saying that these are the layers. Okay, this is only about epidermis. In dermis also, we will understand what are the different parts. But the same thing, the same layers have been named differently, but have been mentioned in our literature of Ayurveda, which is 5,000 years old. Okay, so just to understand this and just to feel that whatever we had in past, the science, the medicine that was developed 5,000 years ago is what is present here with a different name, yoga as yoga, okay, and acupressure as Chinese acupressure. Similarly, the names with modern medicine terminologies are already present in and mentioned in literature which is 5,000 years old. But since we are discussing about the structure of skin, we should know these parts also. Okay, I'll show you one more picture. Let me see if I have the picture. I'll show you. Yes, you see this picture. This is a very beautiful picture which has all the layers mentioned very clearly. So the topmost layer, which we said as stratum corneum. So this is the topmost layer, stratum corneum, and the upper part of it is only the dead cells. Are the dead cells shed off with time? Below it is stratum lucidum. See, this is stratum lucidum, the second layer. Third layer is stratum granulosum, the granular layer. You can see the granules also inside. If you zoom it, you will be able to see the granules. So it is stratum granulosum. So all the three are part of the horny layer. Okay, that is a more hard part of the skin. Below it is the germinative layer, which consists of stratum spinosum and stratum basale. So this is stratum spinosum, and you can see some cells are there in the lowermost layer of epidermis, which is forming the stratum basale layer. Below it is dermis. So this is dermis. So this is the dermis is the place where we have the sweat gland, the lower part. It is the area where the hair follicles are present. It is the area where the sebum glands are present. Okay. So sebaceous gland, the hair follicle, the sweat glands, all these are present in the dermis layer of skin. Fine. So this was about dermis. Sebum glands are the glands which are producing sebum. That means the oil producing glands. When you wake up in the morning and you touch this area, the T zone, then you get oil on the finger. What is that oil? This oil is nothing but the sebum. Sebum is produced by the sebaceous gland, which moistens the skin. If the sebum is not produced in some of the very chronic ailments of skin, you will see the sebum is not produced by the skin, and the skin is very rough and dry and like crocodile-like skin. Why? Because the sebum is not produced. It's not moistened by the sebaceous gland. Now, the second layer, that is, this was about epidermis. Now, the dermis. What is dermis? Second layer. Dermis. Dermis is a layer which is actually thick, tough, but flexible and highly elastic. It's a very elastic layer, and that is why skin shows elasticity. It's thick on palm and sole. It is very thin on eyelids, scrotum, and penis. So male genital area skin is very thin. This dermis is very thin. And it has two zones. Like epidermis has five zones, five layers, and two zones were the horny layer and the epithelial layer, germinative layer. Similarly, dermis has two zones into it. So what are the two zones? The first zone is called the superficial zone. Superficial zone. It is also called papillary zone. And second zone is called deep zone or reticular zone. Okay. So dermis has how many zones? Dermis has two zones. First one is called the papillary zone and second one is called the reticular zone. And you'll be surprised to know that this reticular zone is the zone which is responsible for wrinkles. Okay, so old age wrinkles are because of this reticular zone, because it has some, I'll come into it. It has some yellow filaments, and if these yellow filaments or fibers are degenerating, then the wrinkles appears. Okay, so first understand about the papillary zone or the superficial zone. Superficial or papillary zone. So what is this superficial or papillary zone? It is highly sensitive area. Very high sensitivity is there. It has a lot of vasculature. A lot of vessels are present in this area. Okay. And okay, vasculature. I'll explain it later. These vessels are actually present in some elevated zone which are called papilla. P-A-P-I-L-L-A-E, papillae. I'll show you all these now in the three-dimensional structure. I'll show you where these structures are. So the vasculature is present in papilla. Papilla is the elevated zone. Papilla is actually is a conical projection under epidermis. Okay. So this is about the superficial or the papillary zone. What about this was first one, first zone. Second one, the reticular zone. Reticular zone consists of bands of white fibers and yellow fibers. So white fibers and yellow fibers are present in reticular zone, and this yellow fiber is the fiber which is responsible for the wrinkles in old age. Also, in its deep zone, we have sweat gland sebaceous gland hair follicle and adipose tissue. So this is about reticular zone. I'll show you the picture of reticular zone also. It's a very beautiful picture. Focus on this part. The upper layer, it is called the epidermis. And the lower part is dermis. So now focus only on dermis, because epidermis we have already seen. Epidermis has five layers. Okay. Now focus on this dermis. So in this dermis, you see the papillary layer and the reticular layer. These are the two zones of dermis. So you can see the papillary layer is the layer which has papilla. You can see the elevated zone. So this, only this particular zone is the papillary zone. Below it, you have the reticular zone. What is there in the reticular zone? This reticular zone has the bands, tough bands all over, isn't it? And you can see the sweat gland and the hair follicle, sebaceous gland, different muscle fibers. All these are present in the deep layer, reticular layer. And below it, you can see the adipose tissue, blood vessels. All these are even deeper into the skin. So this is dermis, the second layer or the innermost layer of skin. Now, what are the different properties of skin? This also we should know, because you'll be able to understand a lot of diseases if you know the property of skin. First property of skin is it is pliable, P-L-I-A-B-L-E. What is the meaning of pliable? Pliable means it bends easily. If something bends easily, we call it pliable. It is elastic. It conducts heat. And that is why if there is heat inside the body, you can feel the surface to be heated up. Why? Because it transmits heat. So it conducts heat. Dry surface is resistant to electric current. So on the dry surface, electricity cannot pass through. And that is why you get shock only when the fingers or the body surface is wet. So these are some of the very important properties of skin, and the function, all of you know, it protects, it conducts heat, it prevents the water moisture to get evaporated because it is saving the water inside the body, etc. So all these are the functions of the skin. Now come to the meridian, which is the focus of our study. And to understand this meridian, we are following Pitti's Tree by Mata Prasadji Khemka, skin chapter. So in this chapter only, you will get this location of the meridian. Here you can see total how many points are there? Total 7 points are there. So in Dr. Wall's skin meridian, you have 7 points only. So it's a very small meridian. It is bilateral. That means it is present on both the feet, left and right. Which toe is it? It is first, second, third. So it is on the third toe. Third toe. Which side? It is the tibial side. Tibial side of the foot. Third toe. Okay. Now see the points. What are the different points? SK1, SK2, SK3. Now, I hope almost every one of you know the significance of 1, 2, and 3 now, right? So this is body. SK1 would be for the lower part of the body. SK2 for middle part of the body and the arms. SK3 for the face, skull. All these are covered by third number point. Upper part is so lower part 1, middle part 2, so face, skull, etc. Point number 3. So 1, 2 and 3 are very simple. Easily you will remember. For lower part of the body, you will always choose third number point, middle part 2 and upper part 3. But what are the rest? What are rest of the points? SK1-3 is the CMB. Remember one more thing. Whenever we talk about CMB, CMP in most of the cases, you will see it is just above the middle joint. So this is the middle joint of the toe. How to identify the middle joint? See, if these are the toes on the foot. For fingers, it's very simple. You bend it, and you can see also the lining. So you can see the lines. This is the first joint, this is the second joint, and this is the third joint. But on the toe, it becomes little difficult because toes are very small. toes a little stiff, and also the joints are not prominent. So how to identify the joint? From the upper surface, that is the dorsal surface, if you bend the toe little, you will be able to make out the first joint. And if you bend from the center part, touch your toe and feel it and see. If you bend it from the center point, you can easily make out the middle joint. And the joint on the lower side is difficult to identify. Upper part, it's easier to identify. So identify from the upper part. Okay. So the first joint is from above, at the area where it is bending in the front part, middle joint where it is bending in the middle part of the toe, and the innermost joint is very clear because this is where the toe is attached to the foot. Okay. So this is how you will locate the three joints. So see the second joint, that is the middle joint, beside it, all the points are on the yin-yang border. So this is the yang side, this is the yin side. So on the yin-yang side border, you have all the points, right? So first identify the middle joint, come to the lateral side, come to the yin-yang border side and move little, see if this is the middle joint, come little above it, little towards the nail, little, how much, only half, maybe 2-3 mm. And if you press it with a probe, you have to press it with a probe. Don't press it with a pencil or a pen. Otherwise, it may damage the skin and the area would be really painful. So if you have a probe or a wooden jimmy, you press the area on the third. You press this area and you will find that this point is very painful on the skin joint, skin meridian. So that is SKCMP. So this CMP, you know the significance of CMP. CMP is actually the prime minister of that meridian. That means for any problem of skin, you have to choose CMP. So first point, which is fixed for you to choose, is CMP. And in most of the cases, you will see CMP is just above. Above means towards the nail, just above the middle joint. So this is CMP. So apply a methi seed on this point for any problem of skin, any problem. Okay. Also, okay, first write down what is SK1 is for, so that we understand SK11, 12 and 1A also. SK1 is for lower part of body. It is also for abdomen. It's written in your book only, huh? SK1. If you open the point SK1, you will see all this is written there. Abdomen. It is also for lower back. It is also for legs. So this is SK1. In simple word, how to remember? Below diaphragm, anything, any part. So we can write it as below diaphragm, any part of body. What about SK2? What is this SK2 for? SK2 is for arms, it is for neck, it is for chest, it is for back. That means the middle part of the body. So in simple words, we can say for middle part of body. Okay. SK3. SK3 is a point that will take care of the topmost part of the body. Okay, so this is actually for face and skull. Now understand rest of the points. What are these points? SK11, 12 and SK1A. 13, we know that it is CMP. What is this SK11? SK11 is a point for limb. If you have the diagram in front of you, just beside it only write down. You'll never forget. SK11 is for limb. 1-2 is for allergy. Write it down as skin allergy. See, allergy can be of different types. We have already discussed about allergy in detail, isn't it? Allergy can be of different types. It may show on skin. If it is representing itself on skin, then we say that it is skin allergy. So for skin allergy, we have SK12. Fine. SK1A. See, once I got a question that how these meridians are named as 1, 2, 3 or ABC. Why at some places it is mentioned as SK11, 1, 2, 1, 3 and then 1A suddenly? Why not 1, 4? The reason being, SK first, which point was identified? SK1 was identified. SK2 was identified, SK3 was identified. And after that, it was identified that, okay, there's one more point and it is SK1A. Okay. After finding out SK1A, he discovered few more points near SK1. Now, what to name it as? He cannot name anything before A. Is there anything else which you can write before A? A is already the first letter of alphabet, isn't it? So, he named it as SK11, 12 and 13. Now, 1A. 1A is also a very, very important point because it is a point for scars. Scar may be surgical scar. Scar may be because of any wound, anything which is creating scar on the body, on the skin. So, SK1A is for scar. Now, I'll tell you a very, very interesting protocol. And you can only make that protocol, and that is for contact dermatitis. Dermatitis. Very important protocol. What is contact dermatitis? Contact dermatitis is the infection and inflammation of skin. No, not only eyes. Contact dermatitis means of this infection and inflammation of skin because of some allergic reactions, which may be because of some cosmetic, because of some chemical, because of some overuse of something. So that is creating contact dermatitis. For example, if someone is using yesterday only, I got a patient where the patient was had contact dermatitis, and the cause was excessive use of Harpic. So the person has tendency that every day he'll clean the commode with the Harpic. So every time this Harpic is touching this skin, it has created some rashes, deep rashes on the area. So what is that? That is contact dermatitis. There was a case where the patient was using excessive of the alcohol, your 70% alcohol. Okay. And that caused all over the palm the person had, the lady had actually allergic reaction. So that is contact dermatitis. Fine. So for contact dermatitis, which point to choose first? You tell me. Give me the points. Okay. So we are choosing skin meridian CMP. SK CMP. What else? SKCMP, what is SKCMP? SKCMP is 1-3. Apart from SKCMP, which other point you will choose? You will choose a point for allergy, isn't it? Which point is that? Good. SK12. Along with SK12, because SKCMP you will choose for sure, SK12 you will choose because it is for allergy of the skin. Which other point you may choose? You will also choose the point according to area. If the energy is in the lower part, you will choose one. If the energy is in the middle part, you will choose two. If energy is on the upper part, you will choose three. If it is on the head, maybe because of use of some shampoo or conditioner or some chemical on the head, because of some dye, the person is having allergic reactions on the scalp. So which part, which point you will choose? You will choose SK3, isn't it? So third point would be SK according to area. Which area the allergy is there. So these are the three points you will choose for allergic reaction. Along with this, you will also choose another meridian. Which meridian it would be? Some of you answered. Yes, AD meridian. Very good. AD, why OR? Allergic reaction on the skin. No? So it's a clear indication that you will choose allergy degeneration meridian. Allergy degeneration meridian, which point to choose? First point you will choose is always the CMP. Isn't it? So AD, CMP. What is AD, CMP? AD meridian CMP is AD 1B. 1B. Along with this AD 1B, there's another point with which we discussed also, and that is AD 1A. Why we have 1A? Because this is a point which controls autonomic nervous system. Now you will say, suddenly, why are we choosing autonomic nervous system to treat allergy? How allergy is related to nervous system? See, under autonomic nervous system, there's a video also on YouTube on, okay, we haven't posted it yet, but we'll be uploading it for autonomic nervous system. Autonomic nervous system consists of two parts. One is sympathetic and another one is parasympathetic. So your sympathetic nervous system is a system which always protects you from anything which is happening to your body suddenly. Okay, so even the allergic reactions are controlled by sympathetic nervous system. So you have to choose autonomic nervous system point, and that is AD1A. So remember this, it's an important point. It's a new thing which we have learned today. And along with this, we will also choose AD point according to area. If it is an allergy of lower part, choose one, middle part two, upper part three. So now you can see it has become a very simple but very important protocol. CMP of both the meridians, area according to the location of the disease, one, two, or three, and along with that, two points, SK12, special point for allergy of the skin, and AD1A for autonomic nervous system because it is controlling the nervous system, the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. So it's a very important protocol which you will use because you will get a lot of patients, a lot of people around you who are suffering from contact dermatitis. Okay. Also, there's another protocol which we will use very frequently, and that is for scars. It is written in the book only. So just before this skin chapter, skin degeneration vessel chapter, you have the protocol and it says it is SK1A, SK1, SK2, and SK3. 1, 2, 3 you choose according to the area of the problem, like if it is a problem of lower part, middle part, or upper part. And along with that, you choose 1A because 1A is a special point for scar. For scars, you have a special point. If you don't understand the location of the points or you're unable to explain it to someone that where is this point located, simple and simplest way to treat any skin-related problem is massage on the skin meridian. That too we can do now. Only 7 points are there. And the points are also so very simple that it is starting from a certain area and it is reaching up to the foot area. So just ask the person that you massage the third toe and the channel. The channel where I'll show you. So as a person that you massage this whole area up to here. Up to here, so you are getting the toe. So it's very simple to explain that you massage this third number toe. If you are unable to say that this side or that side, say the whole toe. Massage the whole toe. Give the person a small ring and say that you roll the ring on the third toe. And this is actually the area which is a groove. So say that massage in the groove between the third toe and the fourth toe. So this also treats stretch mark scars, stretch marks. And also if there is any scar of any wound, any cut is there on the skin, that is also is treatable with this meridian. So this is a very beautiful meridian that can be used for many, many of the skin ailments. Now I'll show you the 3D diagram which I promised you to show of the skin. So this is a section, a vertical section of skin. So this is the topmost area, top part of skin. And if I cut a section, I'll see skin something like this. Okay, all around the skin, it is 0.1 to 4 mm only. So the uppermost part is the stratum corneum, which we have already discussed. The topmost part, the horny part, which sheds off, which is the dead part. And below it is the epidermis. Okay. And the lower part is, this part is the dermis. This is the dermis. So if I remove this dermis, see, I've removed the dermis. Okay, I'll remove this corneal layer and the epidermis also. Then you can see the papillary layer also. Can you see the papilla? And inside the papilla, you can see the intensive network of different structures. Like this is the sweat gland. What is this area? This is actually the fatty tissue under the skin where the fat is getting deposited. When we say no, we are getting fat. Fatty. Where is this fat deposited? It is deposited under the dermis. So just below the dermis, you have the fat. And this is the muscle. So fat is not accumulated in the muscle. Fat is accumulated on the muscle. And in between the muscle and the fatty layer, we have the muscle fiber. So this is fascia. Fascia of muscle. That is the covering of the muscle. This is the sweat gland, the red colored structure, this one, sweat gland. This is hair follicle. So there are other structures also, like this is a very important structure, which is a muscle layer of muscle, a single muscle, a rectopili muscle, which actually helps in elevation and movement of hair on the skin. When you have the goosebumps, what is causing the erection of this hair? This muscle, which is attached to the hair. Okay, so this was the three-dimensional structure of skin. So we can use this meridian for different ailments. So this is all about SK meridian. Over to you, sir.
Yeah. Now, once again, heartfelt thanks. Really wonderful, Tushan. So you have the knack of communicating very well in the simplest possible manner. My heartfelt thanks to you, madam.
Thank you so much, sir.